Hello and welcome to Panzer Painting. Today we are going to paint this US 2.5-ton truck. Here you got a chart of the different materials I have used for this project. We start by first applying two thin coats of dark gray to the truck. Let the first coat dry before applying the second coat. Next, we will apply some pre-highlights in order to enhance the look. We are aiming for the upper and most exposed parts. We also have to paint the tarp's most prominent areas, which would be where the frame underneath is poking through, as well as all the creases. We can now start by applying the first dark base color. Here we'll aim for the lower and darker parts of the truck. It would be inside the mudguard, the underside of the truck, as well as inside the cap. Next, we will add the rest of the base color to the parts we didn't paint in the earlier step. This is going to be our base color, and we'll add highlights to this later. Now we can apply the first highlight to the truck. We are aiming for about half of any horizontal and vertical surface. For the final highlight, we are keeping the paint for the very top and most exposed parts of the truck. For the tarp, I'm using canvas from Vallejo. Give the tarp two or three thin coats, and don't worry if you don't get complete coverage. When the tarp color is down, we are going to add some white to our canvas color. Paint the prominent areas and creases again. When you're done, add some more white and redo this step again till you're happy with the result. Now that we are done with the color modulation and everything is dry, we are going to cover the truck with a cloth varnish. It's going to prevent siltering from decals and help us with the pin wash. Let the decals soak in some warm water for a few minutes and then leave them on a piece of paper in order to get rid of any excess water. Apply some decal set to the wanted surface, add the decal, wipe off any excess decal set and then apply decal fix. This will soften the decal, making it conform to the extrusions underneath. Now it's time to pin wash the truck. You could use enamel thinner straight from the jar, but I find that it works better if you mix it with some thinner first, as this will make it flow better. Use a pointy brush, but not the best one of course. Apply this to all the nooks and crannies, and this will make the different details pop a lot more. Thank you. After about 20 to 30 minutes, the enamel wash is dry enough for us to remove the excess. You can use an old brush or a cotton bud for this job. Just dip it in some enamel thinner, wipe off most of the thinner in a piece of paper, and then clean the truck. You can use an old brush in places you can't reach with the cotton bud. However, be gentle. If you rub the same place too often, the paint will get ruined. For edge highlighting, we are going to use a white flat brush to dry brush all the sharp edges. I use the side of the brush and let it run along the edges I wanted highlighted. So next step is wear and tear. This is a two-stage process, and for this we'll use a piece of sponge and a brush. First we use a light green color to symbolize the smaller scratches. Simply dab the sponge in the paint and then remove most of the paint by dabbing it on a piece of paper till it's more or less dry. Then dab it on the areas that would see the most wear and tear from daily use. Repeat this process by using a dark color and apply it but not as heavy. If you're up for it, you can also use a fine brush to make lines across the hull. Now we can start painting all the wheels, fuel cans, ammo boxes and headlights and such. When it's dry, add some shape and then repaint and highlight the different items. For the wheels, we'll mix some gray and white and then dry brush it onto the tires and the 50 cal. We also have to add some highlights to the top. Mix some of your canvas color with some white and run it along the raised areas as well as the different buttons and sharp edges. Here we'll use two sorts of weathering, crime and rain. Simply add them anywhere you think crime and rain would accumulate over time and then let it dry for about 20 minutes before you start blending them. Use a brush and some enamel thinner in order to blend them and do this in a downward motion. Now we have to apply wet and dry mud. Mix some enamel thinner with dark pigment and then apply it with an old brush. When you're happy with that, add some lighter pigment to the outer parts of the mud, as this will simulate the mud getting dry. Use the same lighter pigment on the wheels, then use a cotton bud to clean the vertical parts of the wheel. When you're done with that, we can add some splatter. Start with the darker mix we used earlier. First, load your brush and flick it off with a toothpick. Then second, you should use a lighter mix of pigment and thinner, and if it ends up anywhere you don't like, you can easily remove it with enamel thinner. The final touch on this vehicle is gonna be some oil spills. It works much like paint, and you shouldn't thin it down. You just add it where you think oil and fuel would accumulate. And when you have done that, you're done. Last step is our matte varnish. With this specific varnish, I can only recommend that you don't rush it, and instead give it many very thin coats. If you let it pool anywhere, you'll end up with a pale area. Remember, slow is smooth, and smooth is fast. So this concludes this episode of how to paint a US 2.5-ton truck. I did find this very enjoyable to paint, especially the top. You could of course use these techniques on other vehicles as well. Remember to like, comment and subscribe if you enjoyed this painting tutorial. See you next time.